चक्र जो पूरा हुआ चलते चलते काल चक्र जो पूरा हुआ संगम में अपनों से संगम हुआ
भाग्य द्वारे खुले हमको भगवान प्रभु के गले भाग्य लिखने लगे ब्रह्मवंशी ब्राह्मण ज्ञान गुंजन करे आए अनुभव करे आत्मदर्शन करे अपने पांचों स्वरूपों का चिंतन
ओम शांति गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन सो यू नो बाबा इज द वन हु लुक्स एट अस फ्रॉम द टॉप मोस्ट पोजिशन एंड हिज विजन इज सच दैट ही सीज अस इन अ वेरी एलिवेटेड फॉर्म बाबा नेवर सीज अवर प्रेजेंट इम्परफेक्ट फॉर्म राइट सो इन टुडेज मुरली बाबा सीज अस इन थ्री एलिवेटेड फॉर्म्स and explains each of them then. So I would suggest as we read through the Murli, remain introverted and keep checking yourself as Baba gives each, explains the three forms, gives the signs of three forms. And at the same time, visualize yourself in that elevated form while we listen to Baba. Because we all know power of visualization, right? How it affects our mind and our body as well. So let's see, date, original date of the Murli is 23rd December 1994. Essence of the Murli is constantly keep your three forms in your awareness. Constantly keep your three forms in your awareness. One, confluence aged Brahmin. Second, a Brahmin who is to become an angel. And third, an angel who is to become a deity. Today, Bab Dada is seeing the three forms of the children in all four directions. The most elevated form is that of a Brahmin. And then a Brahmin who is to become an angel. And then an angel who is to become a deity. So the three forms are the Brahmin form, the angelic form, and the deity form. The speciality of the Brahmin form is of, now here Baba explains the Brahmin form, what are the signs of Brahmin life, what are the specialities of Brahmin life. So the Baba says the speciality of the Brahmin form is of being complete with all the paths. Because to be a Brahmin means to be a conqueror of Maya. So let us check ourselves, right? Whether we are complete with all the powers. No? We are conquerors of Maya. So in order to become a conqueror of Maya, you have to become complete with all powers. When you have all the powers, you are the conquerors of Maya, right? Maya cannot create an obstacle for you. This is what it means to become a conqueror of Maya. The first form is of a Brahmin. Check yourself and see whether you have imbibed all the paths, which, as you were just told, is the speciality of the Brahmin form. So first speciality of the Brahmin form is complete with all paths. And because there are all paths, we'll be conquerors of Maya. Do you have all the paths? Or do you only have some paths? If you are weak in even one path, or you're lacking one path, then again and again, instead of having the Brahmin form, you become the warrior. Yodha ban jate hain. That is one who is constantly battling. Right? So Baba says, Yodha kya karega? Yudh karega. No? The duty of a warrior is to battle. And the duty of a Brahmin is to constantly and easily be a conqueror of Maya. A Brahmin means to be victorious. So, first Baba said, complete with all powers. When there are all powers, there is victory, right? There's conquer over Maya. Because you are constantly complete with all powers, that is complete with all weapons. And a warrior means one who is sometimes victorious and sometimes defeated. Because even though he receives the powers, he is not able to imbibe them. A warrior, Baba says, he has the powers, but he is not able to imbibe them. Then what is the use, right? This is why he is not constantly able to be victorious according to the time and circumstances. A Brahmin form means one who constantly has a... Now this is the next definition that Baba gives. A Brahmin form means one who constantly has a crown, a tilak, and is seated on the throne. So what is the crown, what is the tilak, and the throne? One who has the crown of the responsibility of world benefit. Crown of responsibility of world benefit. One who constantly and naturally has the tilak of awareness. And one who is constantly seated on Baba's heart throne. So what is the crown, tilak and the throne? So Baba says crown of seva ka zimmevari ka taj. Crown of responsibility of world benefit. Tilak of awareness and throne of Baba's heart throne. Because a warrior is not constant, unshakable, and immovable. He is sometimes unshakable, and sometimes there is fluctuation. Sometimes he has all rights, and sometimes he has all rights, and sometimes he is a royal beggar who asks Baba for the powers. So, kabhi adhikari ban jate, kabhi adhin ban jate. Keep asking Baba, give me this, give me that. So, Baba says, this is the sign of a warrior. A Brahmin means one who constantly lives a life of alaukik pleasure. So, this is the next definition. Baba says, Brahmin means one who lives a life of alaukik pleasure constantly. A Brahmin is one who constantly has a spiritual face and character. A Brahmin is one who constantly has a spiritual face and character. A warrior means sometimes like this and sometimes like that. So ask yourself, who am I? Am I sometimes a Brahmin and sometimes a warrior? Or am I constantly complete with all the specialities of Brahmin life? So I'm constantly a Brahmin, or sometimes a Brahmin, sometimes a warrior. You have the aim of a Brahmin life, but you do not have the qualifications of sometimes being a Brahmin and sometimes a warrior. Do you? Are your aims and qualifications the same, or is there a difference? So aim and qualification, right? Laksha or Lakshan. Same hone chahiye na. So Baba says, check whether your aim and qualification is the same or is there a difference. Are your words and actions the same, or is there a difference? Right? We say walk your talk. So words and actions should be the same. So Baba says, check whether your words and actions are the same or is there a difference. You are all called Brahma Kumars and Kumaris, are you not? Or are you called the warriors? You are not called this, are you? You do not even like to be called the Moon Dynasty. If someone were to call you the Moon Dynasty, would you like it? कोई कहेगा चंद्रवंशी में आना है तो बाबा सेज यू वोंट लाइक इट राइट नो वन वुड लाइक इट यू वुड नॉट वुड यू एंड व्हाट अबाउट योर एक्शंस सो वी ऑल वांट टू कम इन द सन डायनेस्टी सो बाबा सेज देन व्हाट अबाउट योर एक्शंस टेक अ पिक्चर ऑफ योरसेल्फ व्हेन यू आर एंगेज्ड इन बैटलिंग यू हैव अ कीन इंटरेस्ट इन टेकिंग पिक्चर्स डू यू नॉट These days, there's a lot of craze, right? For selfies, especially. So Baba says, you take a picture of yourself when you're engaged in battling. You take pictures whilst walking along. Do you know how to take your own picture? Or do you know how to take the pictures of others? So take your own picture of who you are. What do you do when someone's picture is not good? You take a picture, and if it is not good, what do you do then? Do you carefully keep it? You do not like it, do you? Right? We delete it immediately. So throughout the entire day, how many times do you become a warrior instead of being a Brahmin? Check this, and then afterwards, change it. You must not just check, but you check in order to change. Do all of you have the power of transformation? Right? When you check yourself and you know this is the weakness or this is where I lack, so then you need the power of transformation to change, to transform. So Baba is asking, do you have the power of transformation? Or do some of you not have it? Achha, it is good that everyone has this power. There isn't anyone here who does not have this power, is there? All of you have said yes to this. It is a matter of great happiness. So Baba is saying, you all have the power to transform. So this is very good. This is a matter of great happiness. Now, do you know how to use it at the time of need? Or you're not able to use it then? Right? If you have the power of transformation, you should be able to use it at the time of need. So now next step, Baba says, now check whether you are able to use it at the time of need or not. Or you remember it, or you can use it after the work is done, after the action has been done. Because if you have the power, it should be useful at the time of need. When there are no enemies, you may have good weapons. And when the enemies come, your weapons are of no use. Would you call that being powerful? You have the weapons, but you're not able to use it at the time of need or when the enemies come. So Baba says, then that's not being powerful. That's of no use, right? So do not just check whether you have the powers, but check whether you know how to use the power that you need for a particular action according to the time. Right? So first is to check whether I have all the powers, and second is whether I'm able to use it according to the time and circumstances. Or do you remember the power after the enemy has attacked you? So check the specialities of Brahmin life. A Brahmin will become an angel. A warrior will not become an angel. A Brahmin will become an angel, right? So Brahman Sofarishta. So Baba is saying Brahman will become an angel. So we need to check whether we have the signs, whether we have the specialities of Brahman life, or there are still signs of warriors. The second form is that of an angel. All of you have to become an angel, do you not? Or is it difficult to become an angel? Is it easy or difficult to become an angel? Or is it sometimes difficult and sometimes easy? All of you know the speciality of the angelic form. Now Baba gives us the speciality of angelic form. An angel means one who is double light. So what is double light? You know this, do you not? So you are double light. So double light means light and light. So two meanings of light, right? One light means light, prakash. So Baba says angel means light. The soul is point of light and angelic body is body of light. And the second is sthiti, the swaroop or sthiti. So the state of mind should be light, which is, you know, free of any kind of bondages, free of burden, of any waste. So that is double light. So Baba is asking, are you double light? Or do you sometimes have a desire to carry a burden and so you carry it? Or is it that you do not wish to carry the burden, but Maya places the basket load on your head? So what is it? Baba says, you carry the burden, or what is it? Maya places the burden on your head. Maya shows her artificial and temporary power in such a way that even though you do not wish to carry a burden, you still carry it out of compulsion because you are weak. The stage of the soul, the state of mind is weak. So Baba says, then you carry the burden even if you don't wish to carry. Anyone who is weak is always dependent on others. So Maya also makes you dependent. You forget that you have all rights and instead you become dependent. So adhikari banne ke bajaye adhin ban jate. So Baba says, you forget that you have all rights and instead of that, you become dependent. And then what is your language at that time? I did not wish it, but I don't know how it happened. You say, I don't know in every aspect. A few days back, Baba said, you know, pata nahi bolte hain. Pata nahi kaise ho gaya, pata nahi kya hoga. To pata nahi kahenge, to pata kat jayega. So Baba is saying the same thing here, that you say in every aspect, I don't know, I don't know. So to be one who has all rights means to be constantly free. To be one who has all rights means to be constantly free. And to be dependent means to be under the influence of others. So one who is under another influence can never have a life of pleasure, right? One who is living under the influence of others cannot experience pleasure. And you were told about Brahmins, that a Brahmin means one who has a life of pleasure. Baba mentioned in the Brahmin form that it means one who has a life of pleasure, alaukik pleasure. If at any time, instead of experiencing pleasure, you become confused, such as, what is this? How is this? Is this what is going to happen? Then this is not pleasure. This is a life of confusion. Right? Kyun, kya, kaise, all this is, Baba says, life of confusion, not pleasure. If at any time you experience a lack of pleasure, then what to do? Pleasure, Baba is, you know, in Hindi we say it as moj. Alaukik moj mein rehna. So Baba is saying, agar moj nahi hai, moonjte hai. If you are confused, if you lack pleasure, then what should you do? Then remember the first lesson of who am I? I am not just a soul, but what type of soul? Right? Baba always says this, right? Don't just remember that you're a soul, but add an adjective to it. I'm a peaceful soul. I'm a pure soul. I'm Master Almighty. All these self-respects that Baba gives us. So Baba says, I'm not just a soul, but what type of soul? How many replies would there be to this question? What type of soul am I? It is a long list, is it not? How long is the list of who am I? Swaman ki list bahut badi hai. So Baba says, how long is the list? You study and hear of many different lessons of who am I in the Murli every day. Right? Every day's Murli has so many these titles or self-respect that Baba gives us. If you see yesterday's Murli, yesterday's Sakar Murli, Baba said, no, you are Raj Rishis. You are very fortunate souls. You're worthy of worship. You're self-sovereign. You're successful souls. So there are so many titles in each day's Murli. So Baba is saying, you study and you hear these different lessons of who am I in the Murli every day. So to be an angel means to be double light. To be light means to experience lightness. Lightness doesn't just mean being light when any difficulty arises, but throughout the entire day, you have to remain light in your nature, sanskaras, relationships, and connections. Right? So, as I said, the sthiti should be light. Sthiti should be light means halka. Light in your nature, in your sanskaras, relationships and connections. There should be easiness, no tightness, right? Generally, you may be all right, but if there isn't any lightness in your nature and sanskars, would you be called an angel? If any soul or if a person is always, you know, very tight in his sanskars, very rigid nature, so we won't be comfortable with that person, right? So Baba says, but if there isn't any lightness in your nature and sanskars, would you be called an angel? And the sign of being light is that anything light is constantly loved by everyone. Right? Angels are loved by everyone. So, Baba mentioned that sign of an angel is to be double light. Lightness means to experience lightness in your nature, sanskars, relationships, and connections. And the sign of being light is that you will be loved by everyone. Would you like it if someone gave you something heavy? If you are asked to carry some heavy object, some burden, we won't like it, right? But you would like it if someone gave you something light and beautiful. Would you not? the sign of those who are light in their nature, sanskars, relationships and connections is that they will be loving to and detached from everyone. Loving and detached. So, nyara aur pyara rahenge. So, angels are loving and detached. Because they have a Brahmin nature, not a different nature. Brahmin means to have a nature, sanskars, relationships and connections that are liked by everyone. So this is another definition of Brahmin. Baba says Brahmin means to have a nature, sanskars, relationships and connections such that you are loved by everyone, you are liked by everyone. You were told earlier also that the majority should be liked by at least 95% of everyone. So at least 95% people should like you. They should have a good relation. We should have a good relation with everyone. There should be this much result. You are even now being given a margin of 5%. This will not be till the end. But you are being given this now. So Baba says now you have the margin of 5%. Means there are always few people who won't like you, who won't love you. You won't have a good relationship with them. So Baba says that margin is of 5%, that's okay. But 95% should be happy. You have to be liked by at least 95% of everyone. That is, you have to remain light with everyone. And this lightness should be experienced through your words, actions, and attitude. Lightness will be experienced through your words, actions, and attitude. It should not be that you think, I am light, but others are not able to understand me. Right? Main to hoon, lekin dusre nahi samajhte hain. So Baba says it should not be this. Generally, many of you think that others do not recognize you. If they do not recognize you, you give them your recognition through your own willpower. Your actions and your attitude should transform the other person. Right? So Baba says your words, your actions, your attitude should be such that you transform the other person's attitude. For this transformation, you just need the power to tolerate. Right? Because you have to tolerate in that case because it will take time to transform. So Baba says for this transformation, you just need the power to tolerate. And what else do you say is the sign of an angel? An angel means one who does not have any relationship with the old body and the old world. Right? Farishta mana jiska koi rishta nahi. So with the Baba says no relationship with the old body and old world. You say this, do you not? All of you remember this, do you not? If all of you were asked what it means to be an angel, all of you would say with intoxication that you do not have any relationships. Would you not? You have become detached from the old body and bodily relations and the old corporeal world, have you not? So deh ke sambandh aur ye deh ki duniya. Baba says angel means detached from all these three. Or does that still remain? Do you still have attachment to the old body? Have you become light or free of the relationships of the body? So now we have to check this, right? Do I have attachment to this old body or to the relationships of the body? Your paternal uncle, your maternal uncle and aunts, have you become free from them? Or do you still have paternal uncles and maternal uncles? Baba kehte na, chacha, mama, kaka, ye sab hai abhi bhi. Are you loving and detached? You are loving, but you have to be detached and loving, right? So you need to have this balance of being detached and loving. You have to live with the relationships. You have to come into connections with them. Be very loving. But at the same time, Baba says, be detached. So this is the speciality of an angel. So Baba says, Baba said, angel means double light. Angel means detached and loving. You make the mistake that when you become loving, you miss out on being as much detached as you are loving. So not able to keep the balance. You either find it easy to be detached or you find it easy to be loving. However, it is still easy to be free of the bodily relationships. Is it easy or do they sometimes enter your dreams or thoughts? Relationships, Baba says, do they enter your thoughts or dreams? Do you remember your maternal or paternal uncles when any difficulty arises within the Brahmin family? So this is very important to check whenever there's any difficulty, any problem, or you're stuck in any situation. So whom do you remember first? Is it Baba or is it any bodily being? However, Bab Dada sees that at the time of such situations, many souls remember their Laukik relations much more quickly than they remember Brahmin souls. The situations make you experience the things you have left behind to be your support. When you have died alive, do you still remember the relations of the previous birth? Jeete ji mar gaye to naya janam, right? So Baba says new birth, new relations. You don't remember the relationships of the previous birth. Your maternal and paternal uncles, your mother and father, do you remember them? Do you have any connection with them? Do they come in your dreams? Thinking about these bodily relations again and again, or Baba says, if they're coming in your dreams, that means there's an attachment there. So when your birth changes, your relations also change. So an angel means one who doesn't have any connection with the old or past. So angel means no connection with the past or old. This is the definition you give. Is it not? So where do they emerge from at such times? Do the broken relationships become forged again? Do you become alive from having died? Markar fir zinda ho jate hain? Baba is asking, do you become alive after being died? So an angel means not to have any relationship with the old, but everything new. So no relationship with the old, but everything new. Bab Dada saw that the first step causing obstructions in becoming an angel is the renunciation of body consciousness. Right? Baba said an angel means no attachment to the body, no attachment to the bodily relations in the old world. So now Baba says, what is the obstacle in becoming an angel? That you lack in the renunciation of body consciousness. And the second step, which is more subtle, is to let go of the arrogance of the body. Right? So consciousness of the body and arrogance of the body. In Hindi, it is Deha Bhan or Deha Abhiman. So these two things, Baba says, they cause obstructions in becoming an angel. Body consciousness and the arrogance of the body. Body consciousness is something common. But the more knowledgeable and yogi you become, the more the arrogance of the body causes obstructions. And there are many types of arrogance that emerge. After being knowledgeful and yogi, Baba says there is arrogance of the body that creates an obstacle. And what is arrogance of the body? Baba explains now. There are many types of arrogance that emerge, like the arrogance of your own intellect, the arrogance of your elevated sanskars, the arrogance of your good nature, the arrogance of your specialities, the arrogance of your special talent, the arrogance of the success in your service. This subtle arrogance is even deeper than body consciousness. So you see, right, what Baba is saying, arrogance of your sanskars, your nature, arrogance of the knowledge you have, arrogance of the talents, the skills you have. So all this is, Baba says, very subtle, very deep. You know what the door of arrogance is? See how the flow of the Murli is so beautiful, right? Baba says you have to become an angel. An angel means one who is light, one who is detached and loving. Then next Baba said, what is the obstruction in becoming an angel? That's body consciousness and arrogance of the body. Then Baba explained what is arrogance of the body. And now Baba says, why does arrogance of the body come? You know what the door of arrogance is, do you not? That is the consciousness of I and mine is the door of arrogance. Main aur merapan. So an angel does not just mean to be beyond body consciousness or the attraction of the body or to be beyond the physical relations of the body. But an angel means to be beyond and detached from the connection of the subtle arrogance of the body. And the sign of those who have arrogance is that, how do you know that you have arrogance of the body? Baba says the sign is that where there is arrogance, they also very quickly feel insulted. So we have to check whether I feel insulted very quickly on small matters, trivial things. If yes, that means there is arrogance. When there is arrogance, the feeling of being insulted comes very quickly because the door of I and mine is open. The correct form of an angel is to be beyond body consciousness and in terms of the body, beyond the arrogance of the body. If you have any virtue or any power, why do you forget the bestower? Right? If you have any speciality, any skill, any talent, Baba says, why do you forget who has given you that? Who is the bestower, right? Baba kehte na, data ki den hai, aise samajhna hai. So you cannot forget who has given you that. And secondly, the easy method to become detached from this is very easy. It is of just one word. Right? First, Baba said, is to remember the bestower. Second, Baba says, the one word has so much power that body consciousness and the arrogance of the body can be finished for all time. What is this one word? Baba, who is Karan Karavan Har, is inspiring you to do it. So the word Karan Karavan Har finishes both body consciousness and arrogance. So these two words, bestower and Karan Karavan Har. Baba says, if you remember, you can finish all the consciousness and arrogance of the body. It is easy to remember one word, is it not? Or is it difficult? Okay, even if you forget all the points, in fact, you must not forget them. But if you do sometimes forget them, you can still remember just the one word. Can you not? Well, Baba simplifies so much for us, right? So he's saying, just remember one word. This is easy, is it not? Baba is Karan Karavan Har. So look how easily you experience the angelic life. On what basis did Father Brahma become an angel? He became powerful and an angel by constantly having the awareness of Karan Karavanhar Baba. So how did Brahma Baba became an angel? Baba says he just followed this one lesson or one word, Karan Karavan Har. Right? You all must have heard the stories of the Yajna. When there were any obstacles, when there was beggary part, Baba was very carefree because Baba had this firm faith that Karan Karavan Har Baba is there, Shiv Baba is there. So you have to follow the father, do you not? Or are you going to follow Maya? No, you have to follow the father. Sometimes even Maya becomes your mother and father. She gives very good sustenance and attainment. So like the parents, Baba says, Maya also gives you very good sustenance and attainment. However, all of that is deceptive attainment, right? Attainments from Maya are temporary, deceptive. First of all, there is attainment and then there is deception. You do have the power to discriminate, do you not? However, sorry, you have to recognize at the right time whether it is Maya or the father to discriminate after having been deceived is not an act of being sensible. Right? After you've been deceived, then there's no point. You've already face the loss. So to discriminate after having been deceived is not an act of being sensible. Everyone can understand after having been deceived. However, knowledgeful souls are able to discriminate in advance and save themselves. So do you understand who is called an angel? So lightness, right? Angel means light. So Baba explained how you can remain light when you're free from the arrogance of the body, from the consciousness of the body. So for that, Baba said two words, right? One, remember the bestower. And second, remember Karan Karavan Har. Okay, so now the third form is an angel who is to become a deity. Are you going to become...
Om Shanti Sharmila Baba.
Yeah, we should stop here.
I suggest we can take a pause here and we can start from tomorrow. We can start the deity form. Will that work?
Yeah, yeah, okay.
We're already at 6:13, so we can take a few moments of silence and then we can churn the mudli.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Thank you so much, sister.
Om Shanti. You all can share now.
Om Shanti. I like these points in Murli today about the angelic form. Who is an angel? Angel means double light, and angel is one who is very loving and always detached, and angel is always light. She is light in the light in the nature and sanskars, and is light by everyone. Om Shanti.
Yeah.
Om Shanti. Adding on to what Sandhya Ben just said, Baba today also mentions that angel is someone who's detached with all old relationships. And he today had given deeper understanding of what is Dehbhan and what is Dehabhiman. And the turning point for me and practice point for me for the day is going to be checking on the subtle arrogance that shows up. You know, it's easy at times to say, I am a peaceful soul. And I may detach at that moment from being in body consciousness, but to also check on various other emotions and feelings that gets, you know, immediately shows up when somebody is shouting on you or is arrogant with you, and you feel insulted. So if when I feel insulted is where I have to check whether I have got into my Deva Dhyan. So very deep journey points on to checking on what is Deha Abhimana. No? So that's going to be the journey point. Om Shanti.
So I'll read what Sister Swapna has written in the chat. Baba says, remember who is the bestower and Karan Karavan Har to finish the arrogance of the body. Yeah.
Right, and Baba, a very easy method he says here is to use only one word, remember Baba.
Yeah.
Such an easy access, and that's what we forget after we start doing our work during the day.
Yeah, Baba explains everything and then he comes down to just one point, right?
Yeah.
And Baba simplified it for us. He said, just remember that Karan Karavan Har, Baba is there. Yeah, Sister Hansa is saying, double light, light from the body and from any such thoughts again. Sign is they will be loved by all. Yeah. Baba said, no, when there's lightness, the sign is that you'll be loved by everyone. And that lightness will be seen through your words, actions, and attitude. Right? Okay.
Am I audible?
Yes, sister.
Speciality of an angel, one is to be double light, angelic form, body of light, means state of mind should be light. So again, when we are influenced by others, if we are dependent, at that time, again, we have to go back to the first lesson. Who am I? What type of soul am I? That is, again and again we have to go back and then come forward. This is going to happen every moment. Then and then we can stick to this Dehi Abhimani, soul consciousness. Because the entire day we are facing so many situations. At that time we are getting confused for a while. And again, we realize, yeah, I am soul. I am a soul. I am Baba's child. So this happens every moment. And that is our testing time. So we have to realize the three steps, which are the pathway towards Baba. First is Brahman, then being a Farishta, and then a deity. So we are still on the journey. What I feel. Om Shanti.
Yes, sister, very beautiful. You know, Baba always says this is the first and the last lesson, that who am I? So maybe we can take this as a homework and make a list today. Who am I? What type of a soul I am? Right? Okay, anyone else? Or shall we start with the meditation? All right, Rakhiben, can we have some music?
Yes, sister.
Thank you.
become aware of your Brahmin form. I am an elevated Brahmin soul. The one who has a direct connection with the Supreme Light. I, the Brahmin soul, I am filled with all power. My connection with Baba gives me the experience of all the attainments, and I feel contented. Internally, there is no battle. My mind is stable and peaceful. And this contentment, happiness of being connected with Baba, of having all the relationships and attainments from one Baba, reflects through my face and character. I am a Brahmin soul, the one who has a spiritual face and character. These alaukic vibrations radiate all around to my Brahmin form, and gradually I emerge my angel form. The one that is double thin. Form of light, and state of mind is that of lightness. No burden of any kind of place. I experience absolute lightness. And fly as an angel up above this old world, old body. With Baba as an angel, my companion, I serve the world. My angelic form, the delight night of God, feeling that I am an angel of God's light, I'm an angel of God's love. And I radiate these vibrations of light and love the entire world. Throughout the day, I practice this drill of being a Brahmin, and a Brahmin to become an angel.
Om Shanti. Let's experience our angelic form for the day, and we shall all meet tomorrow morning at 5:30 a.m.
Thank you, sister. Om Shanti. Have a nice day.